In my last video, I printed these parts for my Mandalorian cosplay using only free STL files. These are the next two parts I finished, but I had trouble finding free files. In this video, I'll show you how I got the finished look for these parts, and how I still avoided paying for STL files. Hey everyone, Danny here with Vader Dad Builds. I've been redoing my Mandalorian cosplay armor with 3D printed parts and only using free STL files. I did find files for the right thigh and the left knee, but I didn't like how they looked, so I decided I needed to make them myself. And in this video, I will also show you how I got the chipped paint and weathered looks for these parts. Alright, so let's get started. Here are the parts that I need, and these are the parts I completed in the last video. After deciding I needed to make the models myself, I needed to figure out what free program to use. Previously, I've only used Tinkercad. Tinkercad's very easy to use and is a great place to start if you're new to 3D modeling, but it does have its limits. And it's not going to work for the parts that I need to make now. I've been wanting to learn Blender, so I downloaded that next. There are plenty of tutorials on YouTube to get started. After watching some of the tutorials and playing around with the tools in Blender, I learned enough to get started. Here's my finished right thigh, and here's the left knee. I'll be providing the links to my files so you can print your own as well. Alright, now it's time to start printing. The print quality is much better when you go in a vertical orientation, but to prevent it from wobbling back and forth, rotate it back about 20 to 30 degrees, so you'll have a better placement for your supports. After printing, I do a quick sanding pass with 120 grit sandpaper. Since this part is so tall and thin, there was still some wobble, so I needed to use Bondo Spot Putty to smooth out the top half of the print. I used a small piece of EVA foam to help spread the putty in the tighter areas. Then there's sanding, primer, more sanding, and a wet sanding pass to get it ready for painting. The finish for the right thigh is black paint with parts of it chipping away to show the silver underneath. To get this look, I started with two coats of a metallic silver. I'm not going with the graphite powder like I used on the chest and shoulder armor, since only parts of the silver will be showing through. There are a few ways to get the chipped paint look. There's a liquid latex you can buy, but I wanted to try something that I already had. One way is to use yellow mustard. I tried that first, but I noticed it was beading up on the paint. So I wiped it up and tried another option, toothpaste. The toothpaste was working much better. You just paint it on with a paintbrush wherever you want the silver to show underneath. When you're doing this, you want to think about what areas would get scratched or dinged. So I make sure to add toothpaste in the edges and corners. There are plenty of images online of this thigh armor, so I looked at those for ideas as well. And feel free to watch this video over and over and over again if you want to copy this look. After the toothpaste dries, I paint the armor with a gloss black. Then I hit it with a second coat. Be sure to wait until the paint is fully cured before the next step. All I do here is chip away at the paint with my fingernail. It's easy to see where to chip away because the areas with the toothpaste will not be as smooth. After chipping away the paint, I rinse it off with soap and water. And here's the finished right thigh armor. I'm really happy with how the chipped paint looks. Next, I print the knee armor. This one was much easier to print. Just print it upside down and no supports are needed. Here we go again, everybody's favorite part of 3D printing. Bondo, primer, sanding, and wet sanding to get that smooth surface for painting. The knee armor will also have a chipped paint look, so I painted it with the same metallic silver. Same thing here, I apply the toothpaste where I want to show the silver underneath. I add some to the edges as well. After the toothpaste dries, I apply two coats of paint. The color I use here is a satin peacock blue. After letting the paint fully cure, I scrape off the paint like I did on the thigh. Then I clean it up with soap and water. I want to add some weathering to the knee as well. I mixed a few shades of brown paint. I watered down the paint before applying it to the knee. I'm still new at doing this, but you really can't go wrong here because the goal is to make it look bad. After painting, I wipe and smear it with a dry paper towel. The last parts to the knee are the guns. I smooth them out and paint them with that same metallic silver. Then I use a super glue gel to attach them. And And here's the finished left knee. I'm happy with how the chipped paint and the weathering looks on this print. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see more like it, hit the subscribe and notification buttons, and check this out next. Thank you for watching.